It was all a dream on the scene, making mean.
Then I came along and changed everything.
From ciphers to diapers.
Green jiggly things.
But the grind don't stop.
We just got a bigger team.
All the way to the top.
Mom, what does that mean?
The time is now or never. We are dream team.
I was gonna get paid for this.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Lyric King, aka Nene, aka whatever it is that you want to call me. I'm back with yet another reaction video. As requested in the comment section underneath one of my other videos, today I will be reacting to Miss Dynamite Put Him Out. You guys already know. The original video link will be in the description box down below, as well as all of my social media links. Be sure that you follow us on IG, Best Friends Since Birth. Also, check out my music page on IG, Lyric Kane Official. Also, in the description box down below, you'll be able to find my other YouTube channel. Make sure that you head over there and check out my music. I'm always giving my 2 cents on somebody else's music. This is your opportunity to give your 2 cents on my music. Let me know what you think. If you like what you hear, then go ahead and give the videos a thumbs up. Make sure that you subscribe and turn on notifications. And so that you don't miss out on all of my latest music videos, original songs, cover songs, remakes, remixes, challenges, and live performances. With that being said, we're gonna get right into the audio. This is not a video, this is lyrics. So audio, let's see what Miss Dynamite has to say for us, or say to us. Lauryn Hill vibes already though.
Sleep in your house on a part-time basis. He gave me from taking care of his child.
That right there was definitely dope. Man, what a powerful song. Totally was getting like India Irie / Lauryn Hill / Macy Gray / I can't even explain type feels from this song. Absolutely loved it. Sunshine Anderson, that's who I was thinking of. Absolutely loved it. Love the way she came on the song, like how passionate she was, how earthy, and she just sounded like a tree hugger. If that makes any kind of sense. But I loved it. I loved her approach to the song. I love the message behind the song. Like, man. Like, definitely going. Ow, I just scratched myself. Definitely going to my YouTube. To my playlist titled YouTube under my music, because I personally feel like I can relate to this song. I don't know how many other females out there. Or even men. I mean, sometimes you feel like you're in this situation and you just become so familiar with it that it becomes comfortable. Even to the point where, yeah, you fussing and you arguing and you and this person just going at each other's throat. He does absolutely nothing right. You guys can never get along, but in the back of your head, you're just like, but why start over? Why? Because you need to. Like, people don't realize that toxic relationships can definitely... they can definitely be way worse. They have way worse after effect than what they do on you right now. Kind of like what she said with the children, especially if there's children involved. But even for yourself, you start setting this idea that this is what a relationship is supposed to look like. And for me, with my relationship, I had a relationship and it was super toxic. Like, to the point where I felt like I was changing who I was. Which is even after I noticed I was no longer who I was, I was much angrier, I was more aggressive. I was to the point where I was being physical, where that's not me. I've always been a person to speak my mind, but I just feel like I was just this person who was so irritated just easily. And I felt like that relationship was changing me. But even after noticing that, I was still like making excuses like, no, you know, this is what's supposed to happen, da 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 da. And it literally took, like, for me, it literally took having my daughter for me to just be like, you know what, this isn't cool. Like, this is not what I want her to think. Like, I low-key want to say, I don't want to put it on them, but I low-key do want to say that's where I low-key got mine from. It's like witnessing my mom and dad. Like, my mom and dad, like, forever and a day, that I can remember, would always argue and then break up to make up. And then low-key, I want to say, like, in the back of my head, without even realizing it, that to me, that was the norm. Like, that's what I was expecting from a relationship. And then literally, like, months after having my daughter, it was just like, you know what, bruh? And I think it was a friend who actually had to put it in perspective for me. Like, would you be okay if your daughter brought home someone like her father? And I'm sitting back and I'm just like replaying the whole situations and just like arguments, disagreements, and just the way I literally felt in that relationship. And I was like, hell no. Like, I don't want that for my kid. And they were my friend was literally like, what are you teaching her? Granted, she was only a couple of months and probably did not remember, not even aware of half the shit that went on. And there was some shit that went on. But still, that right there was my get up. And just to be like, you know what? I can't do this anymore. But I'm definitely one of those person who feel like, you know, everything happens for a reason. Definitely teaches you and it definitely teaches you and it allows you to grow. I feel like I learned so much from that situation. I learned a lot about myself, how much I'm able to tolerate, how much I should not tolerate. I learned what I want for my daughter out of life, out of men, the examples and things that are being set out for her. I also learned just how strong of a person I could be. Like, bruh, like... I also learned when I love hard, like, bruh. Like, I sit back down and I kind of just think, like, bruh, I should have been gone. Like, why was I staying? But just, like, I'm weird like that. Like, in the back of my head, I just always try to find, like, positive things. Like, I always try to think, like, it's going to get better. Or, you know, I need to help this person. And it's not always about that, you know? But, yeah, my daughter was the reason I literally got up and I had to get out of there. So, I thank God. And then, also, I look back on that situation. Some people be like, do you ever regret it? No, I'm happy. Like, that taught me a lot. And then, plus, I got my beautiful little girl out of it, who's literally my best friend. If you guys have not been able to tell by, like, the channel, the flipping video, but that is, like, literally my best friend. So, I have no regrets there. And then, plus, I feel like it was just everything happens for a reason. The good, the bad, the sour, the sweet. those moments actually helped mold me into the person that I am. But I will say this about this, because I've said this multiple times. For those of you guys who know somebody who's in a toxic relationship, just stay there and support them. I say this multiple times because I was once that person in that toxic relationship. You could, as bad as you want to just snatch them out of that relationship, it has to be up to them to make that decision. And to be honest, no matter how much you see or you say they need to be gone, they're not going to make that decision to leave until they're good and ready. So the best thing you can do is just be supportive, be there, be that ear, constantly feed them things, not in a negative way, like, get out. But you can just be like, be there like, you know, that's not what you think, that's not a relationship should be. Suggest books for them to read or give them examples of what it should be, because oftentimes we're just basing things off of what we saw as a child, or some of us didn't have anything to go off of at all, so we're kind of putting together our own patchwork of what a healthy relationship should look like. Get in the comment section down below and let me know, did you agree, did you disagree, was your feeling, did you get Sunshine Anderson, Macy Gray, Lauryn Hill, and all that good stuff type of vibes, or was it only me? Definitely like this song. Go ahead and give this song a thumbs up. Subscribe and turn on notifications. And until next time, guys, peace out. I'm out of here.